the conditions which are required to be a student or a seeker of knowledge. An-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, إِنَّمَا الْعِلْمُ بِالتَّعَلُّمِ. You want to become knowledgeable? Seek knowledge. What is the best way to seek knowledge? In my view, and as my teachers taught me, the systematic way, to enroll in a school, to take regular education with exams, tests, and marks, and it says that you have to write, and a certificate. It shows that you accomplished or you did not accomplish anything. But mere reading here and there and listening to a few tapes and, you know, a few books here and there is good, but it is insufficient. And barely you would find somebody who would study a whole book on his own and finish it. We'll keep jumping from one book to another and from one tape to another without finishing anything. But the systematic education, like if you have a chance to enroll in a school, subhanAllah, I was speaking to some of my students just yesterday, reverts. And I said, how are you doing in your education? I recommended to some the Islamic University online of Dr. Bilal Phillips. And they finished it. This is their final. This is the last semester, 4 years. Because you can study at the convenience of your own home, in your bedroom, in your spare time. You study in the evening, in the morning, whenever you have a chance and you take the test. It is a serious education. You have Mishka, Islamic University of North America. You have Islamic University of Dr. Bilal Phillips. You have whatever. There are many e-learning or distant learning tools available online. So I would advise you and every person who is sincere in seeking knowledge. Keep in mind that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man salaka tariqan yabtaghi bihi 'ilman sahhala Allahu bihi tariqan ila al-jannah." Whoever seeks or takes a path to seek knowledge, Allah will make a path easy for him to enter paradise. Whether you go attend the classes or you take it online, you listen to the tapes, you study in the books and you take exams, because this is all an effort which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would definitely, most definitely bless you for it. We don't have time to speak about the virtues of seeking knowledge, but you have to have sincerity and a strong will and always ask yourself, why are you learning this knowledge? Then the answer should be because an ayah of Surah Fatir in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء. And there is another ayah. قل هل يستوي الذين يعلمون والذين لا يعلمون. The ayah of Surah Fatir says, most certainly those who fear Allah most are the scholars, those who are knowledgeable about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in another rhetoric question in an ayah, Allah saying, are they even? Are they equal? Are they the same? Those who know and those who do not? Of course, the answer is not.